this way, and then this way.
Okay.
No party is complete without everyone's favorite party favor, glow sticks. But have you ever wondered how these little tubes can produce so much light? It's all because of a little bit of chemistry called chemiluminescence.
Huh?
Chemiluminescence?
No, it's chemiluminescence.
Oh.
The first part, chemi, comes from chemistry, and the second part, luminescence, means light. So together, chemiluminescence means light caused by chemistry.
One example of chemiluminescence is the glow stick. They're so popular nowadays, you can find them pretty much anywhere.
Whoa! What the?
All right. No more funny business. Let's see how these glow sticks actually work.
Or you can just do this. As you can see, a bright light is produced. You might think that when you crack a glow stick, you're turning on a switch inside, or that there's a battery inside. But a glow stick produces this light because two chemicals are combining together. Two chemicals are mixed together inside the glow stick to temporarily emit a chemiluminescent light. Let's take a look inside. A glow stick has two parts, the outer plastic shell, which we can see, and an inner glass tube, which you might have not known was there. In the outer layer, there is a chemical called xylem. Inside the glass tube is a chemical called hydrogen peroxide, and a fluorescent dye that gives a glow stick its color. When we bend a glow stick, we hear a cracking sound. This is because the inner glass breaks. The hydrogen peroxide inside the glass tube flows out and mixes with the xylem. The mixing of these two chemicals causes a chemical reaction, and they produce light. However, the chemiluminescent light cannot last forever. Once a reaction reaches completion, the glow stick will stop glowing. This is why when glow sticks are made, the different chemicals are kept separate.
Because they're so lightweight, inexpensive, waterproof, and produce little heat, glow sticks are useful for many different applications, such as diving, police, and military operations.
Woo! Alright!
Let's go to lab now to run some experiments.
Welcome to lab!
Before we get started, let's be sure to wear our safety glasses.
Ready to go!
Alright, in these two cups we have hydrogen peroxide and a fluorescent dye, which is typically found in the glass vial in the glow stick.
And in these cups right here, we have the chemical xylem, which is usually placed in between the glass vial and the outside plastic of a glow stick.
Yeah, let's mix it up and see what happens.
All right, let me go get the lights real quick.
All right. Let's do this.
Wow, look at that.
Yeah, that's really bright.
That was really cool.
Yeah.
I'm gonna mix it back in, mix around a little bit. That's like a nice orange color. So this is exactly what happens inside your glow stick.
Yeah.
When you're cracking a glow stick, you're basically mixing these two chemicals together.
Okay, one more fun fact. Did you know you can make a glow stick glow brighter or dimmer? You can do this by changing its temperature, which will speed up or slow the reaction inside of the glow stick. So, if you put a glow stick in hot water, it'll get a lot brighter, but last for a shorter amount of time. And in the cold water, it will be dimmer, but last longer. Here, I'll show you what I mean. Let's put some glow sticks in and see how they look after a few minutes. Let me dim the lights so you can see it better. As you can see, the one in the hot water gets a lot brighter than the one in the cold water.
Today we learned that when we combine two chemicals, they can produce light. This is called chemiluminescence.